while in the very, very beginning, and I still feel this way, I don't think that there was bioweapons research being done there. And the Chinese released this purposefully. I don't believe that, and there's no real evidence to suggest that. However, from the very beginning, I said, now hold on. The pandemic started in the city where there's an institute that studies these viruses. And we're not considering that the institute could have a leaked virus. And I said at the time, and I still say, accidentally, or, you know, not accidentally, that they were sloppy. They didn't have the proper procedures to make sure that no virus that they were researching leaked. I mean, it's a virus. You gotta be very careful. And I used this analogy. I said, okay, you live next door to a gas station. You're digging a new water well. And when the water comes up, they realize that it's contaminated with materials from gasoline. But the person who pulls up the, you know, the water and says, yeah, it's contaminated from gasoline. And I say, well, it must be the gas station next door. And they say, I don't think so. It could be.
Well, then the first.
Social media said, if you write anything that says it came from the Wuhan Institute, we will delete it, we'll call it misinformation. We'll delete it, we'll call it misinformation. Done. See how he's another Avenatti? He's another Michael Avenatti. No doubt. That's what he is. Another superstar, they ran up the charts. Exactly. Disclose at the time that he had done business with Wuhan. When you write one of these pieces, sources for The Lancet or the Journal of the American Medical Association or the New England Journal of Medical, you know, whatever. Any of these journals, you're supposed to talk about your conflicts of interest. You're supposed to, if you did work with the Wuhan Institute, you have to explain that, you know, you may have a conflict. He didn't. And he was covering his own ass. Just like Avenatti was when people said, hey, he took money from a guy in a wheelchair, which he did. Oh, no, that's just Trump's people attacking me. Desik did the same thing. It's misinformation. It's a shame. That is the state of our media. And now, he has been removed from any committee, any organization researching what the funding. Whether it be clients, individuals have political agendas and they have financial agendas. So, I'm sorry, science isn't always real. Despite that sign you have on your front lawn, it's not always real. It's impacted by politics and it's impacted by money. And as many will tell you, once politics and money enter science, politics and money always win. You're listening to The Jim Polito Show, your safe space.
Prospect Medical Holdings is pleased to report that it has received important regulatory approvals from the Rhode Island Department of Health and the Rhode Island Attorney General. These approvals clear the way for Prospect to buy out its investor, Leonard Green & Partners, and expand its ownership of CharterCare Health Partners. This will allow Prospect to continue investing in CharterCare, including Roger Williams Medical Center and Our Lady of Fatima Hospital. Since acquiring CharterCare, Prospect has invested more than $100 million in capital improvements.